Nelson Mandela ached to come home, say his family. He did today. The last part of a long journey that lasted nearly a century. And the end of 10 days of mourning. A final chance for those who knew him best to say goodbye.
My life is in a worry, and I don't know who to turn. Thank you very much.
His family and friends shaken, their pain amplified because, like in life, they shared him in death. With 4,500 people and a funeral taking place in a tent on his remote farm in the Eastern Cape region of South Africa. His was a state funeral in one of the most rural areas of South Africa, a mixture of power and politics, of loss and family, of belonging and belief. Mandela had a canny knack of building relationships. Many were there, even those who represented the old order. His former bodyguard, a white Afrikaans policeman in the apartheid government, told his message to Mandela.
So what did you say in your head to him?
I just said thank you, you know, because there's so much that we have as South Africans to be thankful for, and we've all said it over the past 10 days. It's been said ad infinitum. I think we'll go on and on saying thank you.
The burial was private. A few hundred mourners walked up the hills of Kounou to say goodbye. His final resting place on a reed mat, carried to the burial site by his eldest daughter. In a grave surrounded by local plants that evoke the journey of his life. Archbishop Desmond Tutu, who in a last-minute drama thought he hadn't been invited, eventually made it, in time to unveil Mandela's tombstone.
And as always, the arch sort of, I think,
Desmond Tutu,
just said a very few words. He just said that as the stone was being laid, it doesn't need a stone to remember him. He'll always be in our hearts. And I think that said it all.
It's actually indescribable when close family and friends were going and putting dirt over the tombstone. You had this sense of finality, but you know, of course, that this is not the end for Nelson Mandela and for his legacy.
There was a circle of Christian priests who stood around the grave. They stood back, allowed the family to come in with traditional rituals. And then the family members stood back and allowed the priest back closest to the grave. And that is absolutely wonderful because it's so wonderfully accommodating. And I think that kind of accommodation speaks to all of what Madiba's been in our lives.
Rest in peace. Yours was truly a long walk to freedom.
Nelson Mandela, finally home after a life journey that was long, proud and honored. Robin Kerno, CNN, inside Mandela's homestead, Kounou, South Africa.